Welcome back, Stasa23 here, back again with some knife therapy. And before I get started, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up so I know you're enjoying the content. If not, thumbs down works as well. And if you like knife content and you're not already, hit that subscribe button. Today I have for you the Kansept Knives Goblin. The Goblin comes in at $138. And the Goblin was also designed by one of our fellow knife lovers on Instagram. He's also a custom knife maker, and that is Noble's Knives, Marshall Noble of Noble's Knives. I'm sorry, good guy. And the Goblin was inspired by a 1984 U.S. Air Force fighter jet, the XF-85 Goblin. And it was compact, yet it packed a punch. So that's what he was going for here. A compact knife that packed a punch, because he said there's so many hard-use knives out these days that he wanted to do something a little bit smaller. That's fine with me. I like smaller knives. If you're not into smaller knives, this probably is not the knife for you. They have it in this configuration with the bead blast, stonewash, and the black hardware and the black clip. And they have it in a satin blade, stonewashed bead blast with blue hardware and a blue clip, or you can get it all blacked out. They all come in at $138 for what I saw. Let's get some specs out of the way. You have a total length of 5.75 inches. Like I said, small knife. Blade length, that is 2.25 inches. That's going to be legal in a lot of areas that, you know, have blade laws 3 inch and under. Your grip area from all the way up here, because it's into a chawl, to right back here is around 3 inches. Your thickness is nice and slim at 0.4 inches. The scale's right here. And your close width in the pocket is also slim because you don't have any flipper tabs sticking up. And it is 1.1 inches. And the blade stock thickness is 0.12. So it's a little chunky for the size. But ground decently thin at, well, nice and thin at 14 thousandths on my particular knife. Also, being such a small knife, and as you can see in the inside, they have milled out pockets on the inside, and you don't see that often in small knives, but that brings this little guy's weight down to 2.32 ounces, so that appeases the ounce and inches. Let's take a closer look at this nice sheep's foot blade. I love the design. I would definitely love to see, let me back it out a little bit. I would definitely love to see him do this in a 3.2 inch blade maybe, or 3 inch blade, a little bit longer handle. God, it'd be a super win. This is going to fit into your like secondary knife carry, say in your fifth pocket would fit perfectly. Let's see what it does look like in the pocket. You don't have a deep carry clip, but the clip's pretty interesting. It's different. It goes in and out of the pocket nicely, and that's what you have sticking up. And sometimes it can ride this way, and the way the clip sits, it sits that far. So go there, or you could pop it in your fifth pocket, and it would fit nicely. Alrighty, like I said, stonewash blade. I like how they kept the Kansept logo small, and you know, at a distance you can barely see it. Just depends on the light. I have bright lights pointing this way, so that's why you see it so well. Blade steel is CPMS 35VN, and I will say I've used this one a good bit, and this Kansept Pelican I've used a lot. And so far, they seem to do a good job on their heat treat. Held the edge nicely. It drops up nicely. And I've sharpened one of them, and it sharpened up pretty easily, deburred pretty easily as well. So hopefully that's across the board and not just this example. Blade is, like I said, slicey. The jimping up here is nice and functional. It is geared toward like being back here, but that jimping is more so for the deployment method. you have two different, or three, I guess you could say. You have this extended part of the tang that uses a front flipper. It works just fine as a front flipper. It's riding on ceramic bearings and a ceramic detent, so nice and smooth action. You can slow roll it. And my favorite with this one is the Spidey Flick. Goes out nicely. I will say I took this one apart because it was running a little gritty. And after I took it apart, cleaned out their grease or whatever they have in there, and put it back together, this thing is super smooth now. It's not a free jopper because it's just such a small blade, but it is very, very smooth with the action. On this side, you have Noble Knives' maker's mark right there. And his name, Marshall Noble. And the name of the knife, Goblin. I like how they kept all that small. I mean, they couldn't really do it too much bigger unless they put it across the blade. This little downward swoop like this, you know, you can definitely, you know, I have a medium-sized hand, and I can crunch up and get four fingers on there. And whenever I did use it like that, when I was trying to put a lot of pressure to the cut, I did it in hammer grip. I just felt more secure than trying to get up here and then the material coming into my thumb. You can hold it back here. You lock in nicely. You can catch that jimping, but I don't feel like I have as much control. But for me, this size knife is excellent for something I always talk about. Whenever if you're doing detailed work, you want to use that tip to put your finger up on top like that, push down, and just pull straight through. I don't want to cut through my mat, so I can pull it off a little bit. Let's see, I don't want to cut my hand either. But does an excellent job of penetrating, and you can control that tip and how far it goes into whatever you're cutting. Just close it up. The opening hole can be accessed on both sides easily. It's not being covered up. You can two-hand deploy it if you want. I meant to say you do have a sharpening choil, and it seems that they have cleared the plunge line. Congratulations. I like how he added this little subtle little indention right here to make that somewhat of a landing spot, a choil almost. It's not going to guard your finger any from the blade, but, you know, use it how you want. Just be careful. Close it back up. You have bead blasted gray titanium. They haven't been tumbled or anything, just straight bead blast. The other version with the blue hardware is stone washed scale, bead blast scales and a satin blade. You have stainless steel hardware that's been coated black. The blue one is also stainless steel that they coated. T8 on the pivot, T6 on the body. One thing that I don't love is that it's not a captured pivot, but they do give you another T8 Torx on the other side. So you just got to use two to adjust. Or what I usually do if I'm just making an adjustment, I will put my thumb on the blade like this and push this direction, put a little pressure on there, and then you can make little small adjustments without this pivot turning because you're putting in a bind. You can also use that method to break it free. You can push the scale down in that direction. You're putting this in a little bit of a bind. You don't have to push hard, and then you can break it free that way as well. I didn't have a problem taking it apart, though. The hardware seems to be good stuff. Let's close it back up. Very minimal hardware with those two. You have also a black-coated titanium backspacer. The pocket clip, I like the aesthetics of the pocket clip. You get so many that just look the same. You know, this is a nice little touch. And being that they have these little slots in there, and it's thin, you get some good spring to it. I was kind of worried with such a small pocket clip. Sometimes it can be very, very hard to get it in and out of the pocket. You do have somewhat of a ramp, and that that pocket clip is staying off the lock bar. If you can see that right there, it's hard to shoot. There you go. nicely done. You do have a steel lock bar, lock insert over travel as well, so you're not going to overextend that lock whenever you're pushing it to the left. You can use it as a lefty. I can manipulate it, but it is a right hand tip up carry only. I guess he didn't want to put, you know, any extra holes on this side. You know, I understand. I carry this in both left and right pocket. It doesn't bother me any. Only ones I don't do that with are ones with a flipper tab, because that could get a little dangerous. I love the fact that you can see this is very clean on this side, because there's no lock bar cut out on this side. They put it on in the inside. I wish more companies would do that. It looks so much better. And I don't think it's any different. The access to the lock bar is nice, because they got these nice little cutouts right there. And I'll tell you what, it's perfect. I can easily get my thumb in there. I mean, I don't know. It might be different if you have some fat sausage fingers, but I can easily get my thumb in there. There's a lockup. It's around 40%. I have absolutely no play up or down, left or right. Mine's bank vault solid. I did hear my buddy Jared from Neve Knives said he had a little bit of up and down play on his. Hopefully that's not, you know, something common. Mine came rock solid. Let's see. Let's get some size comparisons out of the way, and we'll wrap this up with my nitpicks and complaints and my overall opinion. Best size comparison is the Spyderco Dragonfly. These two are pretty much identical in size. And you have the Wee Knives Moat. That is a small knife, but it dwarfs the Goblin. Another small knife that I thought would be big, about the same size, but it's small. It's bigger. You got the Ferrum Forge Mini Archbishop, and one that'll definitely dwarf it. Ontario Rat Model 2. So there you go. Like I said, best size comparison is got to be the Spyderco Dragonfly, in my opinion. Let's see, make sure. Okay, let's talk about a few of my nitpicks and we'll wrap it up. There's not a whole lot. My biggest complaint would probably be this cutout. I really, really wish they would have opened it up about like this, you know, or just came back further with that, because whenever I'm holding it like this, I mean, I don't have fat fingers, and it's these two little spots can pinch on your finger depending on how you're gripping it. I didn't see any problem whatsoever, except with the wood shaving that, you know, when I'm really bearing down. And that's not something that I would really be doing with this knife. You know, I talked about what I would be doing with this knife. So I don't know if that shouldn't be a deal breaker. And your fingers might fit differently, but it is rather small. I mean, like I said, look, this is a small knife as well. And look how much wider. If you would have brought that out, it didn't have to make it any deeper, just brought it out to about right there, I think it would have been excellent. Or just leave it flat. I mean, just leave it, you know, without any cutout. It would have probably been even better as well. Because comfortable, you know, and if you choke back here to use this jimping, that's not the most comfortable either. So I would have loved to see that. I may open it up myself. I would like to see them start to use captured pivots. I don't know if they don't on all their knives, but I know on the Goblin and the Pelican, they're not captured pivots. And that's about it. I mean, I think it functions nicely. You know, I would buy this again. I think it's a cool design. Like I said, I would love to see a little bit bigger of a version. I would buy that one too. And definitely has that fidget factor. If you like front flippers, you know, this might be the knife for you. I find the Spidey Flick is the best, you know, method of opening, or that front flipper. You can also thumb flick it, but it doesn't feel as natural as the Spidey flick and the front flip. So if you have any questions, comments, concerns, please leave them down below. And remember, if you like this video, please give it a big thumbs up. I want to know if y'all enjoying the content. And if you have any questions, comments, concerns, like I said, leave them down below. And I will see y'all on the next one.
Peace.